Mary Potter O'Neill is a flower fan who doesn't hibernate in winter.
Winter's fun because people, I think, are kind of bummed out, or, you know, it's cold, there's not much color going on. People are wanting to get their hands on something green and something living. So I do a lot with workshops, succulent terrarium building workshops, floral design centerpiece workshops. And I'm able to source product, you know, through certain farms in California where I'm still able to get in this really beautiful and really healthy product.
She owns and operates Billy's and Tilly out of her grandparents' farmhouse in Jaffrey, combining her love for family, plants, and all things vintage.
I think overall, when people have plants in their house, you know, it's something living, it's just something exciting to have in their house. But there's also a lot of great qualities with plants. You know, they're air purifiers, they take out certain toxins in the air. And they're a story too. You know, I know I have plants that were my grandmother's and then they were my mom. So plants kind of tell a story, and people, they like to keep them going.
Mary is known for her succulent terrariums. Plants, she says, may look intimidating, but are actually very easy to keep alive.
They don't even look real. They're juicy. They look like you can eat them. And they come in a variety, like so many different colors, so many crazy shapes. I'm always learning. I'm always seeing something that I hadn't seen before every time I go to the greenhouse.
She searches high and low for the perfect containers for her little succulents. And you'd be amazed at what she's able to add a little life to.
When I walk into a shop looking for containers, I have, you know, zero expectations. I'm looking for the funkiest, the coolest, you know, the brightest container. Sometimes the containers that seem almost impossible to plant in are kind of my most exciting project. This is one of my favorite succulents. It's called a donkey's tail or burrow's tail. They're extremely fragile. You'll lose little pieces all over, but they're great because you can just pop them right on top of your soil and they'll actually propagate and grow into another succulent. So taking care of something like this, you'll want to water it whenever the soil becomes completely bone dry.
Mary's favorite part of the process, giving her creations away to good homes and passing on her love of plants and all the life they bring to a home to others.
It is really addictive, and it's a good addiction, I think. You know, it brings a lot into your home, whether it's the air benefits or just making your home beautiful.
Meals first, pastries, comfort, caffeine, and to sit somewhere with life that's serene.
An oasis on a winter's day located right on Main Street in Nashua, Tara Gia is the brainchild of Ari Mikak and her fiance, Mark Elbag.
I say we're an indoor plant store and cafe, and they go, what? And then I kind of describe what we do. We offer classes, and that's one side. People can come in and buy plants, and we'll give them some basic plant care. And then the food side is that we try to keep it as local and natural and healthy as possible with as much of your favorite comforts.
It is a business born out of love for nature, for healthy food, and for family.
The name was Earth for the plants, and Gia is the first three letters of my mom's name. So we named it after her because it was inspired by her. I had grown up around my mom loving plants and taking care of them, and whether we were in a tiny apartment in the city or out somewhere with land, she had always something. It's the best part of the day to go out. If you step behind the counter, you get to go be with the plants. We're always fighting for that part.
She and fellow nature lover Mark say they're always learning new things about the plants, how to care for them, and bringing in new ones for customers to enjoy.
At first, I think people think it's a little bit of a hassle because they're like, oh no, there's one more thing I have to remember every day or every couple of days. But once they get in the routine, A lot of people find themselves even just talking to their plants while they're taking care of them. It's just like, it's almost like a therapy session. It just makes me feel good.
They treat the plants very well at Terragea, even making sure the playlist is pleasing to them.
There's some studies that have shown that classical music helps plants. They flourish in it, and so we play it for them, so they're happiest, and we like it too.
Terragea also serves up breakfast, lunch, and dinner, aiming to fill each soul that walks in with more than the good vibes the plants provide.
Our menu is like 90% gluten-free. It has a good amount of vegan options and vegetarian and comfort. It's very fresh, it's very colorful. It tries to incorporate as much of the plants in it as possible, lots of vegetables.
A big hit is neither plant nor veggie, but their delicious Liege waffles fly off the iron.
It's made from a dough, a yeast dough, instead of the traditional batter, and has Belgian pearl sugar that when it hits a very hot iron, caramelizes, so it's sweet on its own.
There is no doubt that Terragea brings some sunshine to the winter blues, and Ari and Mark are hoping they can send some of that warmth home with their customers as well.
My hope is to encourage people that plants are not as hard to take care of as they might think, and that you can, no matter where you live or you work, you can have one with you, and it can add a lot to your life.